What's going on, guys? Welcome to my YouTube channel. If you're new to the channel, remember to subscribe and do all that good stuff. I know it's been a while, but I'm back with another video. Anyways, today I'm going to be teaching you guys how to do facial expression in cinema 4D. Now there's not a lot of videos, you know, explaining how to do this, because it's very confusing, man. I'm not gonna lie, it's really confusing. But don't worry, I got your back, okay? So just stick around and let's enjoy the show. And by the way, please subscribe. And I recently had a test shot on Avengers Endgame Final Battle, what it's gonna be like with other heroes. So please check the link in the description below and watch that.
Cinematic Universe!
Alright, let's get to it. So, I have Thanos 3D model. So I'm gonna use this to sort of, you know, understand, just to sort of, you know, animate myself. Did I say animate myself? Animate Thanos. So let's get to it. So this right here is, I'm using Octane Renderer, as you see, by my right. I'm using Octane Renderer to sort of visualize how it's gonna look like in the final process. And then, obviously, you have your watercolor right there. So, if we wanna start doing this facial expression, now Cinema 4D has a lot of options, a lot of tools. Honestly, I don't even understand like half of the tools. Just telling you guys, it's really, really, it's a lot to learn about this, but I'm just gonna be in the tutorials. All right, so first thing you wanna do is I'm gonna make this fast. A quick, not 32 minutes, so I'll try. So first thing you want to do is go to select. We gotta click something. Click your model. Now if you do that, it's gonna disappear. My image is just gonna go like that. So what you have to do is create what we call a subdivision surface, and then after this, you just drag it underneath it, and then it brings up all the bluish stuff. I don't know what that is. Well, I guess it's the polygons that are available on the head scheme, you know? All right, so now we have that. What we want to do is go to click our mouse point here. And first of all, I'm going to start with the lower jaw. And then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to press UI to sort of spread it out. Again, I'm going to be fast in this, so you know, please stick around with me. So now that we have that in, I think it's okay, it's sort of not too bad. So, see, the face already moves with that, see? So again, the Octane Renderer kind of lets you see what's gonna look like. I like this. Yeah, so we're gonna use that for now. It's a very quick tutorial. I'm not gonna go into like high details about it. So after that, once you have your polygon selected, just click on set selection, go to select, click on set selection, and you have your polygon selected. So now what we want to do is we want to animate. So I'm just going to deselect all this here. Now I want to animate the upper lip. So I'm just going to animate it here. And UI again, same process. Now obviously I don't want this part to be in there, so I'm just going to hold my control key and then just clean it up. See that? Real smooth. And then I do that again. So sort of that's what you got to be doing, you know? So yeah, let's just do it real quick. Just clean the top. I don't want the top to be there, just the upper side. Yeah. All right, so I'm just gonna complete it here. And so if we play this, let's see how it looks. Oh, not that way. Not that way too. So you see that his lips actually moves with it, and that's just creepy. All right, so now that we have that in, we're gonna click on set selection as well again. So now we have the lower lip, we have the lower jaw, we have the upper lip. Now we wanna do the what am I gonna do next? So again, yo, this is just like I'm just gonna do the cheek actually. So this is just like, you know, what you gotta do to sort of animate Thanos' face or animation on the face. So I'm just gonna click here. Oh, my bad. Wrong one right there. there isn't like enough tutorial. Like, people are just so not nice in trying to do this. So confusing. Alright, so that's just the skin drag. Again, I'm not gonna go into much. Brings you sort of a command, so we're just gonna type in post morph. Yeah, so the second one that looks like a thumbnail, something like that. Yeah, so now that we have this in, we are gonna click on the mixing and then move on to points. Yep, so we have our points. So what this here is our poses, okay? So now it's at you know, default pose. So we are gonna start our animation with the lower jaw here. So now, this is very tricky, so pay attention. All right, if you want to do this, we already have our lower jaw selected, which is the polygon here, right here. So I'm going to click lower jaw here. And now that we're there, we're going to go back to the pose morph tag. And then we're going to click on the lower jaw. And then we're going to move this down or up, any way you want your animation to be. I forgot to do the teeth. Look at my life. I'll do it soon. So I want it like that, okay? So that's how it's gonna be opening its mouth. So now that we've done that, next thing you wanna do is click back on the lower jaw and then go to animate, and then you have this. So you see, it's really easy to do, okay? So you can see it's talking and doing all that. So I'll just reset slider here. Actually, I'm gonna do the teeth because that just looks funky. You know what I mean? It looks really, really funky. So I'm just gonna do the teeth real quick, if you guys don't mind. The teeth to do will be very, very easy because the joints are already selected for you. So I'm just gonna select the teeth, then click on UW, and everywhere is selected. See that, yo? Everywhere is selected. And now I'm just gonna drag, you can drag the teeth down, and then it goes with it. Quite easy, eh? So I'm gonna set selection. In the same process, and that's it. All right, so now we're back to our morph graph here, pose morph, and then we're gonna add another pose. I'm gonna make this the lower teeth, so that as the jaw is moving, the teeth is gonna move with it, you know. All right, so let's do that real quick. So I'm gonna click on the teeth. I know now you can't really see it because its mouth is closed. But just drag it down. Yeah, just drag it down. That's it. Click back here, do the same process. And now we have our lower teeth. Okay, actually I moved the teeth on to the wrong direction. Oh man. So I'm just gonna delete this for now. Do that again. Ooh. Lower. Teeth. So I dragged it. Okay, I think you're gonna drag it forward. So you see, it's quite confusing, yeah. I'm not gonna lie. All right, let's open his mouth real quick. Yep, that's it.
Swear I won't forget this, why do I regret this? In my mind reckless, thoughts are feeling endless. Sitting up, I'm breathless, anxiety's infectious. I feel so defenseless, betrayed and embarrassed. I hate being open, I hate being broken. I feel like an ocean, filled up with emotion. Anger ain't a potion, rub it on like lotion. I can feel it soaking, reopen, the scars have awoken. I can't move on till I let go. I feel so lost, never at home. Need to be strong, every breath hold. Cause I can't move on till I let go. I can't move on till I let go. I feel so lost, never at home. Need to be strong, every breath hold. Cause I can't move on till I let go. Every breath hold, cause I can't move on till I let go. I can't move on till I let go. I feel so lost, never at home. Need to be strong, every breath hold, cause I can't move on till I let go.
type of thing that you have to know about animation, really, especially face rigging. Okay, so you can invest a lot of time trying to get that perfect animation. It's up to you. If you have the time, you do it. Okay. All right. So I actually created an environment here. I'm just gonna show you guys something here real quick. All right. So y'all, this is the environment I created. As you can see, there's a bunch of flowers, grass, and I got Thanos. I don't know what he's doing, but you know, it's right there. So yeah, man, you can explore this. Now, most of these materials, like the grass, the flowers, I got it from Bridger. It's they really have 8K materials that look so realistic. And look at this, it looks so beautiful, man. It's like sunset, right? So I love this. I love this, man. Maybe I'll just give it a daylight. How about that? Let's change the light a little bit. Make it look like it's sunny. Really, really sunny, you feel me? Like bright, like that. All right, so let's come over here. Actually, I'm gonna take off Thanos' arm because his arm is gone. You guys know what I mean. I'll take off his arm. Yeah, because Thor sliced his arm. You feel that? See that? His arm is gone. Anyways, if you guys like this video, give it a thumbs up, man. I hope it really kind of help you understand how to face rig. I know it's very broad. It's very, very broad. Trust me, it's very broad, man. And it takes practice and just you trying to explore, what you can do with this software called Cinema 4D really helps, to sort of better your animation. So if you guys like this video, give it a thumbs up. By the way, I did some sort of a test shot. I'm gonna put the video link in the description below. I'm sure you guys are gonna like it because I really put in a lot of work. I know it's not perfect, but it's just, I was testing out this Octane renderer and it really worked well for me. So if you guys like this video, give it a thumbs up. We'll see you guys next time. Take it easy. Peace. Woo!